much. And now, Professor Hasan Hüseyin Aksoy, thank you for coming all the way from Turkey. Before I introduce you, I want to say I had the delight to dine with you yesterday, and it was so interesting. I told him in the end I want to be his student. Aksoy is working in the Department of Educational Administration and Policy Faculty of Educational Science in Ankara University. He's studying a subject are politics and vocational education, politics of technology in education, equality, equality and reforms in education. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Hello to everyone. First of all, I would like to thanks for invitation to have a dialogue and to give a chance to share our knowledge, experience, opinions on education with you. Another point I would like to share that you know that we are feeling very sad, also in conflict. Maybe the importance of the things is changing. You can understand that suddenly what is important is for me for now that is the life of the human being. Life is every time we feel is important, especially from very ourselves goes to away. We feel more stronger for ourselves, our relatives, our friends, and very lately maybe for others. We are putting some peoples as others and don't feel much about them. By the way, I would like to send my condolence to my friend, actually friends, I know some of them, then his family is, my comrades also, to couple, a couple days ago murdered in old city in Jerusalem, and for the Palestinian youngs murdered, I think six was in a couple days ago murdered, for them, for their families, and we don't generally feel the sadness if we put ourselves only one side of the life or human being, and we need to change our point of view sometimes, and to see other grief, others' griefs, and the feelings. We hardly decided to come here because in airport very much deeply we thought, and at the end we decided to be here and to share while our friends are mourning, and it will continue 4 years with that mourning, this struggle, and the developing our ideas about that problems, the reasons why we meet that conditions, then this kind of dialogues and the meeting I hope will help us to figure it out the reasons and the develop a way to reach better conclusions. I'm an organized person. I'm a member of union. I'm a member of a local organization that mostly protest some things decided by high level politics, about electricity, about environment, about education. They don't ask what they will do about ourselves. They don't do what we'll do. They don't say us. They don't ask us what they should do about our life. Just they try to do, and we also try to have our life in our hands, and sometimes we can't be successful. Sometimes we made some decision delayed, wait there until we are becoming not interested in that issue. Then suddenly that issue comes again to the table when the power become more powerful. I will talk on education. Actually, neoliberal reforms of in Turkey, privatization of education, this is the title of my presentation. I would like to follow my PowerPoint. Is this? No. Sorry. I have to be able to obey the time as much as I can. There is here, I found. I hope the Google gave me through letters for Ankara University in Hebrew. I'm not sure.
That's all right.
That is some words. It works at others' life. It doesn't make any sense to us. We don't know, and some others also. Is important for me, and you don't have any sense with that, then we will going to try to make a way to connect, continue to communication by a way. What I will try to tell in this presentation, what is being changed, especially meaning of the education. What is education, and what is becoming to turn? Who is making that change? Who is responsible? Who gave the that responsibility to that groups, companies, organizations, peoples, why they could feel so powerful to say that education should be that pay, your education should be that way, you should learn this. No, I would like to learn another thing. No, you have to learn this. This kind decisions internationally is being made, so we mostly follow the decisions in different ways. Some is very strongly, some sort of soft, some flexibility we can have in some issues, but some of them we have to follow the rules because we have no any choice. Just former presentation said on core issues, they provide us that this is the core. You should learn this. What is an education to me is a process, something provide us to learn new things. By different actions we do this. But in an organizational, in an organization, in organized process also become the main things as education. Nothing can be valued as education. You know, my English is not well. You can understand easily. I took it from school. Believe me that my Turkish is better. Even when I went to primary school, who taught me that language? My mother and my family out of school. So that's not valued because there is no certification. No certification, then you don't know anything. That value provide with the documents. So education changed the meaning. What's happening about the change? They provide us that you will learn this and you will learn by that way. In the issue, I will go fast, maybe in the next issue. Not go deeply in some cases, because a lot of reforms is being held in education system in Turkey, but they are very coordinated, very well coordinated into each other, with each other, headed toward to neoliberal economic system. So neoliberal system ideology approve that reforms, almost all of that reforms. So we can think that almost all is only one reform. Only one education reform is being held one by one. What can be seen in education is also related with the people, and the people is diverse. So education should be different at different places for different peoples, for different groups. So the aim of the education should be develop the peoples themselves, emancipate themselves in society, and the relationship between the society and the individual, not one of them is oppressed, the other should be. I mean, should not be oppressed, one of them to others, individuals and the society. What is the strongest one about the education issue now is the worst is markets. What is the markets? You know that we are selling, buying some things. And if we are selling, buying education in market, like markets in schools maybe, education becomes not a tool to develop ourselves, become a commodity. The commodity, if you have money, you can buy it. If you don't have money, you can't buy it. What we are saying for years that education is a right. Education is right. So everyone should have it. Not depending on their economic conditions. Everyone should have right to access education. Who should provide this? Who should provide this? Society. Society is responsible to provide education to all. Then how? By state institutions. By state institution, education should be provided to all citizens. Marketization of education and the turning education into commodity is a process all cover our life. Commodification education of education change everything. First of all, the meaning of education. We are taking education not we like to work on that issue because it will be able to have more economic value in the future. Exchange value we started to give value. Changing education in Turkey not being realized by institution in Turkey, organized in Turkey, not by the people of Turkey, not by the people will go to the school and the learning will going to learn new things will change their life. Mostly international institutions is defining new way for education for Turkish education system also. One of them is the most important actors, one of them is World Trade Organization. How World Trade Organization made influence in Turkish education system? Because the GATS, General Agreements of Trade on Services, agreement, we signed this, that we will try to obey all items in it. If there is some resistance against that items, governments have permission to delay that conditions to do later. I mean, if you have resistance in your country by the people, organized people, don't want to pay for education, so you made this with little fees, little charge you can do, but you should made it competitive, you should open the market, you should open the international market, the education institutions, education process. So this is a deal and signed by the our government. More than 100 countries signed that agreement. They have to go with that conditions about changing their education system. So we should wait that more than 100 countries will change their education system almost the same way. So I see some changing in Israel education system is under pressure about more private schools, opening the subject into the market. You can't continue to only relate it to building a nation issues. You should teach the people, your students, the issue regarding the market, regarding international market, not only about your country's issues you should teach. World Bank, give money and give conditions. That that issues you will going to teach. In 1990s, Turkey has $95 million to develop its higher education system, and then my faculty departments, some of them closed, some of them newly founded, depending on that deal. And a big money, big part of the money goes to teacher trainers, and which country and which departments will be the education places defined by the institution who give the money for that. So we finished the project, and our education, higher education system changed as well, especially teacher education system changed by that money. And a lot of different project is being continued now, is being continued at different levels. OECD also now is mentioned here, defined our education system, what should be taught in our schools. PISA says us. PISA defend that issues is important. So you should go better than 34. We are very close at that numbers. 35, 36 sometimes, and when we put the 32 or something, 2 point better, oh, we were going to celebrate it. Our head of program in Turkey about education mentioned that we will change everything in education regarding to PISA conclusion. What we're going to taught, what we're going to teach our children, what PISA questions is being asked. So we will ask our children what the OECD experts sees important for us. So we change our problem programs. We had a new problems, I think. IMF. Okay, I'm going to run. Another. I won't give samples, but IMF was an important order commander of Turkey about the issue, what we are going to do. EU is now take the control of our education system. It's very strong to give positions to us. National governments, not much, but is a like a contractor, subcontractor. As a subcontractor, provide conditions in education. And the business organization provide us what should we teach in our education. The issue about vocational issue is important for them. They like us to produce labor force, qualified force. And the another point, they need qualified, good worker with religious obeying feeling, because they don't want to enlightened people, enlightened graduates with the resistant feelings in their mind. So they like to obeying people for as their workers. I would like to mention that the reforms in education, as well as in other areas, is being applied with not the convincing. These coming with the violent power. Why coup d'etat in Turkey happened in 1980? Not because of the anarchy, chaos or something. Just before then, at 24 January, globalization about the Turkey, or opening the Turkey into the global economy, happened a decision, but it was very hard to make realized that time, because the people was organized well. They know their rights, and the workers in unions was so strong. Kudeta destroyed all organizations, killed a lot of people, and they make happen to Turkey's economies, open the global country economic system. Another is discriminative public policy. By that way, you are privileged to learn this. No, you are going to learn only vocational issues. Now in Turkey, you can't believe that if you have a children or child in voluntary high school, if you can't afford to buy education, enough education, no any high school, general high school to send. Only prayer schools, vocational schools, and the open schools, out of schools. So if you like him or her to go upper parts of education, you should have pay money for that. And the ideological institutions, ideological power is being used by families, law institution, unions, media, all is strongly giving information on side of the neoliberal changing. Okay, I will close in a minute if you let me do it. Education.
3 more minutes.
Thank you. I appreciate. I will take short in discussion. A part of the neoliberal reforms related with the public-private relationship. I mean, a part of the public side is going smaller. But actually, it's 5%, maybe you can say that, a private one. But we are talking and trying to make solutions only private schools. So, actually don't provide strong enough, big enough education to people in Turkey, but we all dealing with the problems of private schools, and we as government, as people, trying to develop the private schools. Some cases we try to make as new in education, campus schools. We like to take many educational institutions together, lower than higher education. So like a university, but what we'll do at the end, we will give them as private schools to entrepreneurs. So entrepreneurs are going to run the school in campuses. And another marketization issue in Turkey is the in public schools, even using all technological tools, depending to market, and a very big amount technological tools is not actually being in being used in classroom, but buying to develop the budget of the some companies. Another point is conservatism. Turkey education system is either capitalist way is going and also is conservatist way. You should learn your religions, your culture, your religion values or something. Another way is you should be prepared to run in market very well. And the system actually managed all together by one ideology. It is neoliberalism. Thank you very much. I will cut from here. If you have any question, I will be glad to try answer. Thanks.
Thank you very much.